What's up, guys? It's Fat Leonardo back again with another video. This one is of my week nine battle against of the PBA against Kyle. Don't know if you remember or not, but I battled Kyle. I believe it was my second Wi-Fi battle, the one where I had the battle until he healing wish Victinian. Score Victinian started destroying me. He won a really, really close one. It was a really good battle. So yeah, I'm playing him now in the PBA. He's also got a YouTube channel, KyleQuadFour. I'll put it in the description. You can check it out. He's cool. Sub him. Yeah, this guy's his record is 3-4, but I think. But last season he had the joint best record among four of us. There were four of us that had the same record. Kyle was there, so he's a top opponent. He already beat me, so I'm not taking this easily at like not taking this lightly at all. I'm very serious here. I really want to win, but I don't know. Kyle's good, so it's gonna be tough. Let me just go over team a little bit, kind of like a team builder of sorts. So what's happening is I've got Scolipede here. Scolipede is my lead because I want him to lead Victini so that I can just smack him with an earthquake and bring him down so low that a pursuit will kill whether he switches out or not. And you know, just in case he does switch out, I've got pursuit and he's dead. Dead Victini. So I think if I kill Victini turn, like if he leaves Victini and clicks V create, I think I just win. Because he's gonna have no Victini. His team's gonna be a little passive. That's what I'm gonna dare say that. If he leads Victini and clicks V create against my Scolipede, I'm just gonna win. I'm gonna dare say that. Scolipede also has. So earthquake pursuit spikes toxic spikes. So the idea is if when I kill Victini, I'll be at 1 HP and I'll have so many speed boosts that nothing can outspeed me. So I need to set up a layer of toxic spikes and just let it go down to whatever wants to kill me. Now, if he doesn't bring Blastoise, who is his only spinner, he's just done. So for Blastoise, to make sure he doesn't spin anything away, I brought specially defensive Calm Gengar. And the reason for that is because especially defensive Calm Gengar can set up a sub on Blastoise, on a regular defensive Blastoise, and it doesn't get broken by a Scald. So Scald does not break my sub, which is great because I'm going to come in, spin block him. Hopefully he doesn't predict that. Hopefully he clicks rapid spin so I don't take any damage. And then the next turn you either switch or Scald. I mean, why would he? I don't really know why he'd switch. He'd probably want to just wear me down, or maybe click Mirror Code, expecting a T-Bolt or something. But I set up a sub, and with the coverage I have, Energy Ball, Shadow Ball, Focus Blast, I hit most of his team. So if I'm behind a sub, I just start tearing his team up. Just start tearing it up. And everything comes in on Toxic Spikes, on all my hazards, because I do plan a hazard stack him. Then I've also got Charles Vane, or Jack Rackham, the Chestnut, with Spikes, Seed Bomb and Drain Punch, because those two stabs do quite a bit of work to Kyle's team. and Spikes and Synthesis. So he's specially defensive. He's my main answer to Keldeo. And in case he's being slick, in case he knows that Keldeo, even physically defensive, walls... Even physically defensive, Chestnut, walls Celebi. In case he's being slick and doesn't scarf his Celebi and packs HP Flying, I'm making myself specially defensive and with a Koba Berry. Because I come in on him, he clicks whatever he clicks. I hopefully don't get burned if he clicks Scald. Then he thinks he's being slick, goes for the HP Flying. I live it because of the Koba Berry, and I knock him out with Seed Bomb, hopefully after enough hazards. And Chestnut's going to stack the spikes. I think there are 5 mons on his team that let Chestnut just freely spike stack him. Then I've got Garp, my Avalog, which I need to rapid spin because I have no recovery, or the only recovery on this team is Chestnut, and yeah, basically the team gets worn down, and I can't let Scolipede lose my Sash because Scolipede was the only thing I prepped for Victini. it's pretty bad, but I'll see how it works. I'm hoping maybe the Trick Room late game cleanup is going to help take out Victini. I'm hoping, Scolipede's the only thing I prepped for Victini. That's a dangerous game to play. Also, Garp has an Oka Berry, so that even if Victini is banded, he can't one-shot me. I hope I have rocks up by then, because he hits me with a V-Create, I roar him out, so he takes rocks on the first switch in, and on the second, and the Toxic Spikes, and then the next time he comes in, he takes rocks again, takes some Toxic Spike damage, maybe even Spikes, so I'm hoping... So, like, it's you know, it's not really 4 Victini. Roar isn't 4 Victini, but the Okaberry is, just to make sure that even if he's banded, I can take a hit. And I need to spin away the hazards, because I can't lose my Focus Sash. And I don't want Ferrothorn to spike staff me, so yeah. Avalog and Ferrothorn just sit in front of each other all day, nothing's really gonna happen, so I'm hoping he doesn't hazard staff me. And now, my two mons that are gonna be doing the work and late game are Gardevoir and Mega Camerupt. Mega Camerupt, HP Ice, Flamethrower, Ground Move, Earth Power, and Stealth Rock. Unfortunately, I have to, because I draw Metagross, I can only put Stealth Rock on my offensive options. And I wasn't bringing Lando, so I had to put it on Camerupt, and rocks do too much to Mence and Victini for me to not bring him. And then the other three moves are pretty standard. HPS just to make sure I one-shot the Mence. Now if he's Yatchberry and hits me with an Aqua Tail, that would suck, so I have to be really careful. I would prefer to not have to have Camerupt match up against Salamence. If I could, I'd like to have Gardevoir do it. Which brings me to my Trick Room, Shadow Ball, Moonblast, Psychic Gardevoir. Now this set has nothing for Ferrothorn, and I decided to do that because I'm like, maybe Gengar will take out Ferrothorn, maybe Chestnut will, maybe Camerupt will. So I've got some answers, so I decided to just take care of the rest of his team with Gardevoir. And anyway, after I set up a Trick Room, he just comes in and kills me with a Gyro Ball. So it wouldn't matter for Ferrothorn. So Moonblast one-shots Mence, Shadow Ball hits something, whatever. Yeah, anyway, it's good coverage for his team. And the one last thing is he has Nidoqueen, and for that I have a Kevia Berry on my Gardevoir. It was either that or a Babiri Berry on for Mence Iron Tail, but I don't think he'd be running Roselli Berry. I think if anything he'd be running Yash Berry. So there's no point of me really putting a Babiri Berry for an Iron Tail, because I'm just going to outspeed and one-shot with Moonblast. So, yeah, Roselli Kebri Berry lets me live any one poison move from Nidoqueen and then kill it with a Psychic. So, yeah, you know, in case I'm not behind a Trick Room, that's the deal. So that was a pretty long intro, so I've kept Kyle waiting long enough, so let's see what he's got. He brings... Mega Diancie. I didn't even talk about Mega Diancie because I didn't really prep for it. Why didn't I prep for Mega Diancie? I hope Trick Room takes it out. So he's got a interesting team. I'm really glad not to see Mence, honestly. Oh, he didn't bring Electros. That is beautiful, because Camerupt cannot kill Electros. He brought Ferrothorn, unfortunately. I would have preferred if he didn't, even though I prepped a little bit for it. I would have liked it if he didn't bring Ferrothorn. So Ferrothorn, Blastoise, that has got to be spin. Victini. So who do he could very well lead Ferrothorn, and we could trade a bunch of hazards here, which wouldn't be a bad option. He could also lead Nidoqueen to get the Toxic Spikes up. Diancie, he could lead Diancie and Rotom. I'm a little surprised to see Rotom, but okay. I'm gonna lead Charles Vane like I planned to do. And if he leads Victini, I think I just win. Please, Kyle, lead Victini. Lead Victini and click V-Create. If he clicks V-Create, I think I just win. Because he doesn't have much offensive pressure after that. Diancie, Rotom. Diancie just dies to Trick Room Camerupt. He could lead Diancie to get off Protect, though. That looks like a Diancie. Oh, yes. Oh, Kyle. Oh, Kyle, you have no idea what you've done. Hit me with a V-Create. No U-turn, please. If U-turn pops my stash and I have no way to get this HP back. Bye-bye, V-Create. I'll see you later. So that's a... this is amazing! This is beautiful. Victini. I wonder if he knows he can live this EQ. And then he's thinking he's gonna switch. He's not gonna see the Pursuit Trap coming. Oh, yes. Alright, this is gonna do a lot of damage. good. Yep. Oh, just straight Okos. Wow. Great. So, Scolipede 1. Ah, this is perfect. This is... Yes! I didn't prep for Victini much. And now he's down turn 1. So this is amazing. This is beautiful. Now, that's really interesting because I think he clicks Rapid Spin here. Because it kills me anyway, and in case I want to set up a layer of hazards. Now my switch is not to Gengar, because the idea was that Blastoise comes in and gets hit by Toxic Spikes. I'm already in a good position here. If I go to Jack Rackham and I get burned, that's terrible. I may as well just get rid of Jack Rackham. I'll go into Jack Rackham and I hope I don't take a burn, because I don't want to take a burn. I'm going to set a layer of spikes here. We'll see. What should I do? Is he Rapid Spin? HP? You gotta be kidding me. What is this Blastoise? That's some kind of offensive Blastoise? I think it's worth it to Seed Bomb. If I can wear this guy down and then start stacking my hazard, that's gonna be perfect. Oh, we didn't bring the Keldeo! That's what I was missing. That's good, that's fine. Burn my Koba Berry, so he outspeeds here, so he's free to go for an HP. Probably should have clicked Synthesis here. Seed Bomb may not have been the best play. He goes for it. So I have to switch now. I click Seed Bomb. I can maybe find out a spread now. That looks like defensive, but I'm getting cocky just in case. Just gonna hop over to my calculating computer. What's his name? Seed Bomb. What the hell is this guy's name? Chestnut. Chestnut. Specially defensive. Specially defensive Chestnut. Blastoise, regular physically defensive. Blastoise. Bulky Spinner, let's assume. Oh, what the hell? Alright, what's that? How much does a Seed Bomb due to him? I did a little more than I thought it would. Makes me think he's got some kind of investment in special attack. So how much does a HP Flying do? HP Flying does 42. It did more than that. That's some kind of weird Blastoise. I don't know what he's... Maybe Assault Vest? I'll bring in Doflamingo. He switches. Interesting. That's really weird, because I think he'd have killed me with another one. Oh, this is perfect. This is perfect. Now, I would have been good to Drain Punch. It would have helped me out there. If I Drain Punch, if I like stayed in to do whatever. But this is fine, because I can set up a sub on him and start firing a Focus Blast. And I'm an idiot, I didn't max my PP on Focus Blast. That's stupid. That is really dumb. Hopefully Leech Seed, he sets his rocks, fine. He's gonna Hazard Stack me, that's fine. Because I will get rid of these hazards, one way or another. Who's he got left, actually? Nidoqueen, Victini, Blastoise, Ferrothorn, DNC, Rotom. There's not much of an opportunity to spin, actually. I need these rocks gone, so I may need to switch Garpin right now. Click Focus Blast. I connect. This should do like 30 to 40% because I've got no special attack investment. Depending on his spread, that's good enough. That's good enough for me. Knock off my leftovers. Good play. That's going to pop my sub. Oh no, it doesn't pop my... it doesn't lock off the leftovers. Does he want to lose Ferrothorn here is the question. He's got leftovers, so that's not great. I'm just going to hard switch into Garp now, I think, because gone wore down a little bit. I need to get these rocks out of here, so I switch. He clicked pretty fast. He's probably going for knockoff to knock off my Okaberry, which is I should have run Rocky Helmet. I don't need an Okaberry now at all. He's gonna go knockoff. He can spike stack me here. He can't do any damage to me though. So if I rapid spin, I'm gonna take another huge hit, but I outspeed him so I can recover on him. I think it's worth rapid spinning here. You know what? No, I'm gonna recover because no matter what he brings in, who would he bring in here? He would bring in maybe Nidoqueen, does not want to take in that ice move that I have. Blastoise is worn down. Yeah, Blastoise would be a problem. I should have run Mirror Code after all. I'm gonna rapid spin here. I don't want these hazards on my side. If he switches, so be it. He's worn down. I'm gonna take Iron Barb's damage plus maybe a Gyro Ball, but that doesn't really matter. If he stays in, I can recover on him. Yeah, leftovers are a problem. I'm not sure how much Avalanche is gonna do. And I take Iron Barb's damage, so it's gonna be a bit of a stall here. Does withdraw, so recovering would have been a good option. Goes into Blastoise, that's good. Now I'm pretty sure he just one-shots me here with any move, and I don't take Iron Barb's damage, but again, Doflamingo is a good switch into Blastoise. But let me just calc how much a Blastoise would do to me. It doesn't matter. I'm gonna go into Jack. No. I think I'm going back into Doflamingo. Blastoise. I need to get these hazards up. I need to set a layer of spikes with Scolipede. That would really start to wear down his team. Layer of Toxic Spikes. If I go into Jack, no. I'm gonna make the predictable switch into Doflamingo since I did it last time. So he stays in. Scald, right? Alright, don't burn me, please. Don't burn. Oh my god! That's the one thing I needed. I really needed that not to burn. It probably takes an Energy Ball. This burn cancels out my leftovers recovery and does a little bit more. He can't pop the sub. I have coverage for his whole team. Nidoqueen, Blastoise, Ferrothorn, Rotom, Deancey. So if I set up a sub now, I don't think he can pop the sub. So I'm gonna go for it. My opportunities to do this are running out. He may switch into something else, predicting something slick from me, but I'm just gonna set up a sub in case he switches and no, he can't pop the sub. Oh my god, if he couldn't get the burn, I'd be in such great shape here. But his whole team is getting worn down. Rotom dies to Flamethrower, Nidoqueen dies to Earth Power, Blastoise dies to Earth Power, Ferrothorn dies to Flamethrower, Deancey dies to Earth Power. So his whole team, now this should not pop my sub. I calc, I made sure it didn't. Perfect. Now I've got a few turns to just tear up his team. He's probably maybe gonna switch. And for that reason, I might not go Energy Ball. So depending on who he goes into, I've got my Gengar. Gonna run some calcs here. Gengar, my Spideff version, my HP 252, Spideff 252, calm. If Energy Ball kills, I'm clicking it. Energy Ball does kill. It's a roll, but he's a Solvest, this won't kill, so let's see what he is. He's a Solvest, okay. So I've got a bit of a decision to make here. If Gengar goes down, but I get these hazards up, then it's not that big of a deal for me. I can't get behind another sub, so he may make an aggressive switch into Rotom or Deancey. because Rotom or Diancie will definitely... Or you know what? Shadow Ball should kill from this range, right? Yeah, Shadow Ball's gonna kill from here. If he goes into Ferrothorn, I go for my Shadow Ball, then Focus Blast. Okay, I'm gonna go for it. Shadow Ball. If he goes into Diancie, that's probably his best play. He can't go into Nidoqueen, he sacks Blastoise. Perfect. He doesn't know I plan a Hazard Stack him. It's a crit. Oh my god, that may have mattered. Check this. Shadow Ball? Yeah, I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe it mattered. So Nidoqueen has to go for an offensive move here. I also find out what his set is. Now, is it worth me keeping Gengar? No, it's not. There's no reason to keep Gengar. So I'm gonna click... Oh, why did I click Energy Ball? It doesn't matter. He's gonna outspeed me. I should click Shadow Ball. Ah, that's a misclick. Mistake / misclick. I might outspeed him. He does outspeed me. And he's physical with Ice Punch. Now, I'm pretty sure Gardevoir lives. I can't start sweeping yet because my... Yeah, Ferrothorn's still around, so if I go into my Mary Reed, make a really insane play here, set the Trick Room, and go into Camerupt. Alright, let me write down kill. Gengar 1. He's got Diancie, Rotom. Rotom dies to a Flamethrower, Diancie dies to an Earth Power, Ferrothorn dies to an Earth Power, Nidoqueen dies to an Earth Power. Alright. I'm setting up my Trick Room, and then I'm going to go into my Camerupt. If he goes into Ferrothorn, that is not a winning battle for him. His Camerupt just rips this team apart. Let's see if he's scarfed. He looks like he may be scarfed. He outsped me, but I had no speed investment. Is he thinking about clicking Poison Jab here? If he does click Poison Jab, I live it because of my Kebbia Berry. Trick Room has negative priority, so I'm gonna go second here no matter what. It looks like he's scarfed, which is perfect for me. He does go into Ferrothorn, Nidoqueen, one kill. Now, set up the Trick Room. The biggest problem here is that I need this Ferrothorn gone. If I go into Chestnut and start clicking Drain Punch, Rotom is an easy switching. You know what? We'll sweep later. Let's get Chestnut back to full because I don't want my Camerupt to take two Power Whips. Gyro Ball. That's perfect. So it looks like looks like he doesn't have the Power Whip, because I wasn't sure if Camerupt could take two Power Whips, so I'm going to heal myself up to full. By heal myself up to full, I mean, I'm going to set a layer of Rotom is such an obvious switch, and he's going to burn me. This is my switch into Rotom. Oh, actually, Bartholomew is with the Trick Room. Yeah, that's fine. I'm gonna click Synthesis here because this is my best answer to Ferrothorn. Knocks off my Cobra Berry? Okay, that's fine. It's really weird what he's doing here. I think he'd go into Rotom now. Now I'm at a range to live anything. I live a Moonblast from a Diancie. Maybe. I think that one's actually a roll. I live any hit from a Nidoqueen, I think. He didn't especially defensive. I'm gonna set my spikes, set a layer. Let's start this hazard stacking. So that's his rocks, good play. I still have Scolipede, so I don't wanna take these rocks. These hazards are not that important right now. I think what matters is killing this Ferrothorn and then sweeping with It goes into real time now. Dancing. Perfect. I live a moonblast. After this recovery, I live a moonblast. Because of this investment. Again, depending on his spread, but I think I will. The dimensions return to normal. That's not a problem. I don't... What's Dancy's speed? Because I can get a layer of spikes up here if he wants to protect. I think he's just going to click Moonblast. What's the... Isn't it like 50? So I think I would outspeed it. Dancy's speed... Yeah, it's 50. I don't know. I'm going to go for Seed Bomb. I don't really have another play. I hope he doesn't... It's not a prediction I really need to make at this point. I'll be just clicks Moonblast because I lived this. I'm 99% sure I lived this. I caught this beforehand and I lived it, and that I think I killed a Seed Bomb. Yes, okay. Good thing I went for Seed Bomb. I think I lived this. Get him, Chestnut. Let's go. This should kill. And it does. Chestnut. One kill. I outspeed Ferrothorn. Train Pitch is going to do an okay amount. Nidoqueen. I think at this point, Scolipede has done its job. Maybe. I live the rock switching, so Scolipede has done its job. Yeah, I'm going to sack my Scolipede now. This dude is really vulnerable to Trick Room. Now he's got no flamethrower resist, so I can prompt. So if he wants to go into Rotom to avoid the Earth Power, I click Flamethrower, and that Rotom goes down. If he's like Toxic Spikes, that's good play. Good play. It's a really good play here. I'm gonna go into Gardevoir again. No, I need this friggin' Fairphone God before I can sweep. Is he scarfed? Alright, this game is really in the balance now. After Toxic Spikes, my Jack Rackham goes down. So, Nidoqueen. Oh no. Died to. So, Ferrothorn gets a kill because of the rocks. Now I can go into Gardevoir here. Set the Trick Room because of my Kebbia Berry. I live any one hit. Or. I'm gonna go to Garp, actually. Just give me 1 second, I'll be right back. Alright, I've got 23 seconds, I'm gonna go into Gardevoir. Get poison here, unfortunately. Take rocks. Not sure if I can still live a poison jab. I'm going into Camera. It looks like he's scarred. Or I'm going into Fairy Shellman. What's it called? Camera. I think I have a sweep on right here. Now if I... This Rotom is Focus Sash. That would win him the game, I think. I would need to get these rocks up. I know he's got a Gyro Ball coming. Fire resist it, and I'm slow as hell. Unfortunately, Camerupt is gonna get poisoned. But I'm doing this now. Looks like he doesn't have the Leech Seed. So, Gyro Ball, Stealth Rock, Knock Off. I don't know what his last move would be. So now I've got 4 turns of Trick Room. Okay. I need Gardevoir to win this game. Because I have no way to kill his Nidoqueen without Trick Room. I sacked my Scolipede, and I didn't have Protect on it anyway, so if he was Scarfed, he would beat me. Yeah, those Toxic Spikes were huge. So it looks like he's Scarfed. I could've... If I knew he... Yeah, he's Scarfed. If I knew he was Scarfed, I would've gone straight into Ferrothorn and click Flamethrower, because there are no switch-ins. Would he really bring Focus Sash Rotom? No way. And he doesn't have HP water. He's scarfed with HP ice. Maybe he's not. Is he scarfed? I don't know. I don't really care who you. I mean, this Rotom has to be. This Rotom has to be sashed with. HP. This Rotom has to be sashed with HP water. That's what it goes down to. This Rotom has to be sashed with HP water. Unless he's defensive. I could be throwing away the game here. But I'm just gonna go for the flamethrower. There are no switches to this. I outspeed under the trick room. Make camera finally get put in the work. Now depending on his spread, he might live this. But if he's like max speed, max special attack, he goes down. There are no switch-ins to this. And those are just like poison spikes, not toxic spikes, so I'm taking 12% per turn. Yeah, would he really be HP water? I doubt it. He needs to be, in any case, if he's not Focus Sash, I win here. I think. Yeah, if he's not Focus Sash, I just win. He switches. So it looks like he's not Focus Sash. Goes into Ferrothorn to sack Ferrothorn. Fine. I like that. Mega Camerupt. One kill. Alright, let's go. It's finally time for Mega Camerupt to shine under the Trick Room. Finally. Finally. Flamethrower. Gone. Not Okaberry. Okay. Nidoqueen. Not Focus Sashed. I know that. Rotom. Might be sashed. If Rotom's sashed, I think I'm screwed. Unless Gardevoir can take a hit after rocks. Yeah, Gardevoir would have to take a hit after rocks, and then he's got Nidoqueen who beats the rest of my team. So. I think he's gotta go into Nidoqueen and bait the Earth Power. He doesn't. Why? He has to be Focus Sash. He has to be Focus Sash here. He has to be Focus Sash. Let's find out if he is. The only other hope is that I live a Poison Jet from Nidoqueen, but I don't think so. At the range I'm at with rocks and poison, I don't think I'll be able to take it with Gardevoir. But if. Oh, I've got Garp! Garp can take any hit and return. Oh, you know what? After all that damage, maybe not. Please don't be Focus Sash. Please don't be Focus Sash. Yes! Camerupt! The monster! The boss. Bartholomew. You can't stop him. What are you gonna do? It's time. He finally makes his appearance finally hits the field. So you're scarfed? I don't care. Do you have Aqua Jet? No, not a problem. Clicking Earth Power and winning this game. Yes! Finally, Mega Camerupt putting in the finest. Amazing. That's beautiful. I beat Kyle. Oh man, I was so excited for this battle. Mega Camerupt put in the work. Mega Camerupt put in the work, finally. No, I'm telling you, it's a great pick. It was a really good pick for me. They said he was a joke, but nah. Mega Camerupt is no joke. So, thank you, Kyle, for the battle. That was really intense. If that Rotom was sashed, I think I lost the game. So, great game, Kyle. And thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time.